facilities suck. But you're not listening to the good stuff. You're not listening to the right stuff. Well, I know I've been told this. I've been told this through school. I've been told this from friends in the neighborhood. I've been told this by my cousins, even at home, by my brother, by my father. They're both musicians. So I've constantly been told that the music I listen to is shitty. You know, well, I have to be honest, I've told people that too. But you know what that is? It's because everyone's listening to the right kind of music. There is no wrong kind of music. In fact, there's not even wrong music for a particular situation. Let's take an extreme example, like a funeral.
You might think that at a funeral, there should be instrumental music or some light, severe wind instruments, or some ancient bhajans, or some prayers, or chants, or heavy metal. Did I forget to mention that this funeral was from that cat with a wicked temper? But honestly, you could listen to really loud, banging music, and that could bring you in full focus if that's what works for you. So the thing is, really, the music is about what you take from it. That's the right kind of music for you. What makes you feel connected, and what makes you feel inspired, and means something to you. So, I'm a musician. I started writing music when I was 13. Started writing these songs. I don't even talk about those songs. They were quite funny back then. I started playing guitar when I was 14. And I started performing when I was 15, out in public, not just in school. When I was 15 and 16. And what I thought, what I liked about music back then was, I didn't do it as a profession. I didn't think about doing it as a profession. I actually didn't think about doing anything back then. I was very content with my one best friend, who was my partner, not doing anything at all. But I started performing, and it made me, in my awkward teenage years, feel more connected to myself. And I realized it also gave me this incredible ability to connect with absolute strangers, to touch them and even move them with songs that I had written from my heart, from my experiences, at that age, when I was so young. And I didn't even have to know who they were, and they could relate to me and we could experience something together. So many years later, I was in this long relationship, and it had finally come to an end. I didn't know who I was then. I lost myself, because so much of who I was tied to this other person. And when they were gone, I was lost. So I did what felt best. I went to my trusty guitar, I started strumming it. I had a conversation with myself. I was really unraveling. And I started with the simplest thing, which was, who am I? What am I? And I looked out of my balcony at this huge expanse, which was the golf course and the race course. There was lots of trees and lots of greenery. And I saw these big trees standing alone deep in the earth by itself, by themselves, swaying in the breeze. You know, and I said, I am a tree. And that's how it started. But then I said, I'm bigger than a tree. I mean, if we're being metaphorical, I'm bigger than a tree. And I said, I'm a field. And then I said, well, hell, I'm the sky. And that's where the song was born. And it started with me trying to find all the different things. Can we go back? Yeah. I started to write all the different things that I was doing at the time, trying to find myself again. The things that I liked to do, the things that I was doing. I was trying to find who Alisha was by herself, without someone else to lean on. And eventually it turns out I was a maniac. And this is the song I wrote. So the only way I could get back to feeling wholesome and connected to myself was through music again, you know? And I wrote very honestly about how I felt and who I was. And in the most simple way, I had this personal moment with myself. Can I put the guitar on?
Everybody else echoed it. It was like they were validating their existence, that they were there, their spirit was there. And they existed. It was a sound of defiance. Think about it, it was liberating. These people who have nothing, they have their humanity, they have their spirit, they have their integrity, and they have the fact that they were there together doing something as one people. Husbands, wives, daughters, sons, brothers, sisters, all of these people in these in huge lands, acres and acres, over acres and acres of land, synchronized in one rhythm. Can you imagine that? Singing together, validating themselves. Kind of like a marathon runner hitting her stride. With such ease, it helped them pick cotton more efficiently. And no one could tell them to stop because it made their work better. It made them better at what they did. So nobody said stop, but it was their tiny act of rebellion. You know, in that time, blues was actually the wrong kind of music. Because it broke all the rules, it was unstructured, it was nothing like what the slave owners listened to at the time. And, you know, even the scale, the blues scale, added notes that aren't in any other scale. They added notes that weren't in the regular scales, and it's called the blues scale. And these notes were actually called, ironically enough, worried notes. So there is no right music, there is no wrong music, and it just shows you that anything can be the right kind of music. So when you listen to music and there's something that you don't like, honestly I tell you, with all of my heart, you should give it another chance, give it 10 chances. Listen to it with an open mind. Listen to it again, listen to it with someone who loves it. Let them take you through it. Let them show you why they love it. You know? Because everything in music, every specific genre will give you something that you didn't know of before. Blues never existed, and now it's changed the way people look at music forever. It's this whole new aspect of music that came out of their struggle. It was their musical thumbprint, their imprint and sound. They existed, they were there, they even put it in the sounds that they have, that we all have now. So, and the best way to learn to love something that you haven't heard before, to experience music, is to go listen to it live. Because when you're live, when you're listening to music in a concert, or with someone right in front of you singing to you, playing a beat, if you've ever gone to a drum circle, music's not just in your ears, it's on your skin, it's in your heartbeat. Everything's moving together. It's actually tangible. You can feel it. People who can't hear can feel music. They can feel rhythm. So, let me tell you a story about how I went for a metal concert. It was India's biggest metal festival. It was a 2-day long festival, and I'm not someone who listens to metal a lot. I listen to a lot of that folk rock stuff. But I went because my friend had tickets which were free. I'm all for free stuff. And I had a great time. First day, I saw all these guys and girls with long hair, all dressed in black. It was sweaty. It was tough. People were pushing you, they were slapping you with their hair. They were headbanging all over the place. But the energy was nothing like anything I've ever felt before in my life. The whole place, the ground was shaking with these people. They were running into each other, they were moshing. You know what moshing is?
Yes.
Does everybody know what moshing is?
Yes.
It's when everyone goes crazy and bangs into each other. Now, I can't understand it, but I sure felt it. And it was pretty amazing. So, the next day I went back with this whole new feeling. And, well, this is what I looked like the next day. Does that play? Oh, well, it's a video. Yeah, I'm too bad to bend over metal anyway. But I went back and I had a blast. It was a great festival. So give all the music a chance. because there really is no wrong music, it's all the right kind of music. And in my opinion, music is best, and it works for me, this works for me, is to be present with music in every moment. Because if you're present with music in every moment, anything could happen. You know, as much as you rehearse something, as a performer, I rehearse things just as anyone else. I go over my chords, I go over my songs. But when you're on stage, you don't know what's going to happen. I went to Chennai to play a gig, and I was in the middle of my performance, and there was this huge storm that blew in. But I was so in the moment, and the audience was so connected to what I was saying, and we were all together on this journey. You know, I was singing these songs that I had written so truly, that they were actually drawn into the songs with me. That even though it started raining, I didn't stop because I was in the middle of my song. And it was open air, and nobody moved. Everyone sat right there with me. And then the sound guy said, "Alisha, you have to stop. You're going to get electrocuted." So I stopped, and together all of us ran into a shelter. That's what being in the moment is. It's having the whole audience and you stand in the pouring rain just for the music. So I want to leave you with this one thought. Music is feeling. And if you feel something, be true to your feelings.